Hello and welcome to a new video here on my channel, here at commaik. Today I will be expanding the existing diesel tank in my mobile heating box. I will replace this 2.5 liter tank with a significantly larger tank. If you want to know how it works and how I do it, stay tuned. It's about to start. My heating box reliably provides warmth to the animal house in winter. Even at 20 degrees, I have it there. Inside, the temperature is pleasant 10 degrees Hax to pleasant 15 degrees Hax. The birds love it. The center features a diesel stand heater. The air is drawn from the animal house, heated in the diesel heating system, and then returned. The house is blown back. The exhaust gases are expelled through this exhaust hose to the outside and onto. On the other side, I have the adapter for the combustion air. I have one problem. However, this tank holds 2.5 liters of diesel. With that, I can only manage 2.5 days in winter before I have to refill the tank again. And what do I do now? I will replace this tank with replace a larger fuel container. I will exchange this tank for a gasoline canister. Replace. I chose the canister so that it is placed directly next to the diesel heating system in the box fits in far away from the hot exhaust. And now I need to see that I have the hoses for the... I need to somehow get the pump into this gasoline canister, but there is also a solution for that. And I bought an adapter set that I will now install in this tank to connect it with the gasoline canister to connect to the diesel pump. The container has a capacity of 10 liters, four times the size of my previous tank. With that, I should definitely make it for a good week before I have to refill the tank again. The set that I purchased for this consists of a gasoline hose and a metal adapter set. A fuel filter is also included, along with two transitions to connect the gasoline hoses together. The metal hose can be bent relatively easily, and in length I can simply cut it off. On the other, at the end is the transfer point for the gasoline hose, which is essential. The diesel pump then draws fuel from it. This metal hose draws the fuel from the bottom out of the gasoline canister. The special thing now is that the construction should be airtight, because my heating is not 100% in the box. Airtight. If vapors should escape here, it may happen that these vapors through the air currents being blown into the animal house. I definitely want to prevent that, because my budgerigars are very sensitive to these toxic fumes. For this reason, I bought a special gasoline canister that has a vent valve on the back. This valve is normally intended to facilitate the transfer of fuel, such as if no air enters the canister during the transfer, diesel cannot flow and sloshes instead from the tank nozzle. With this model, that cannot happen, because on the back side, there is an opening where air can flow in easily. The opening is at the back here, fits relatively well for my hose. With a bit of force, I can fit the metal hose, push in, but I cannot secure it at this point yet. For this reason, I will also drill a small hole through the lid where I will attach the adapter accordingly. Can be secured, then the adapter can be screwed tightly and airtight to the gasoline canister. Thank you. The installation took a little less than half an hour. I connected the hose from the old canister, connected the canister to the filter on the new canister. The metal hose is lying slightly on the ground can thus suck out all the diesel from the tank. You can already hear it in the background. Clicking of the fuel pump. The pump should deliver the diesel up here in a few moments. Suck in. Then I will test whether the entire system is even tight before I put it into continuous operation. The diesel heater has now been running consistently, efficiently and smoothly for approximately 10 minutes without any issues. And I can confidently confirm that I have thoroughly tested and verified the system. The connections are all tight and nothing is leaking anywhere. I can see on the side how much diesel I actually have in my tank. I think that I will manage with a 10-liter tank for a good week without having to refill the diesel in between. What interests you about the project? What do you want to, what would you like to know from me? Just write it in the comment section under the video, what you think about my project. If you want to know how I built this mobile heating box, then take a look up in the corner. There I will link you to the videos about building my heating box. If you want to know what I have installed here and which components I am using, then take a look. Also check under the video. There I have linked all the products that I am using here. You pay the same price and I receive a commission. This way we both benefit. I would like to thank you at this point for supporting me and my channel through your purchases. Supported. At this point, I am already done. Don't forget to give me a like. If you enjoyed my video, subscribe to my channel to not miss any new videos. I am looking forward to the next video. Until next time, take care. Ciao.